What's a biomarker and are they useful here?
So biomarkers are ways for us to predict. I mean, there's different types of biomarkers, but most of the time when we talk about a biomarker, we want to predict which patients have the most benefit and maybe also predict which patients shouldn't get a treatment, so to unnecessarily treat somebody with an ineffective therapy. So for immunotherapy, people have looked at biomarkers, and there is this assay called PD-L1. It's linked, obviously, to PD-1. And right now, I would say that I wouldn't recommend using a biomarker to decide on treatment. People are testing, and it's somewhat helpful. But the key point is that even if your biomarker is negative, even if your PD-L1 negative, there still is a significant chance of having benefit from the treatment on the order of about a 10% response rate and probably even more impact on survival.
10% in people with the negative biomarker.
With a negative biomarker. And otherwise, it's probably double that number if it's positive. So that is very important because if you have a negative biomarker and you have significant benefit, I don't want to exclude you from this treatment. So it is an interesting biomarker, especially if you have a situation where you really, really want to know if it's going to work or not. So if you want to enrich, but I would still treat everybody with this. And the way that I view these drugs getting approved in the United States, they will be approved without a biomarker. So it's more of an interesting thing. I think we have to do better. I think there's new biomarkers coming forward. Those might be available through clinical studies, but right now I would not recommend using that. And I would just use it, and I would just try the medication.
And plenty of smart people such as yourself are working very hard on getting biomarkers that will actually be usable, and hopefully we'll be able to have a future segment on the success of these.